our stands. Two claps. Woo! Very nice, guys. Now, little man. Boom! Ready and a punch. Tap.
Isn't this great to see? I mean, he has really turned out to be a good teacher. Who would have thought? Mark, a good teacher. I do attribute this to my leadership training here at AMAI. It's second to none. Let's take a walk. I want to talk to you. Tell you about one of our programs.
Ready and go. Give yourself two claps. Give me a double up. Boom! And ready. Woo. Go, Dad! Cross, cross!
It's good. Jump. It's very good.
Push incredible martial arts today.
I wanted to talk to you a little bit about a program that we do called Mat Chat.
Uh-huh.
Come on over here. Mark will be okay. He's got a really good handle on the kids.
Super quick. Awesome job, guys. Give yourselves two claps. Two down low. Woo! Ready and jab. Cross, cross. Jump.
They're in really good hands. Come on.
All right, guys, focus stands, please. Very nice. You saved yourself 100 push-ups. Do you know why, Keyshawn? I'll tell you why. Because you guys put on an excellent show from Master Ron. Now, let me take this shirt off. Let me put the real one on. See if you mark here now. You guys ready for a little pain? Oh, I'll make your mind up for you. Everybody repeat after me. Jump!
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 Keep it real!
Keep it real!
Get it on!
Our mat chats are really what we're all about at AMAI. There are special words that teach positive, just positive energy, encouragement. They're encouraging words to build character. Words like awesome, words like super, words like marvelicious. These are words that kids don't hear enough of today, and it's really important that they hear stuff like this.
So, to improve our students' training, I've asked Master Ron if I can include some additional material to our mat chats. Now, our mat chats, as of late, have been a little soft. They're arming our students with the skills to be bullied, basically. I mean, can you just picture one of our students in line at the water fountain and one of the school bullies pushing them and him turning around and telling them all about self-confidence and respect and all these, you know, ridiculous concepts. So I'm going to initiate some of my own vocabulary and see how that goes. I'm gonna introduce the kids to my world, the cruel, like sadistic world that we all kind of live in, but I'm only really fully aware of. All right, we're done talking about friendship, our actual word of the month. We're gonna talk about CP Mark's word of the day. Everyone say blunt force trauma.
Don't get this. I'm not sure where he's
let
going.
Me ask you.
Hold on.
Suppose you're in the lunch line.
Just
some big old bully walks up and just slaps you in the back of the head. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do, Cassie?
Tell the teacher.
Oh really? Alright, everyone say goodbye, Cassie. Bye, Cassie. Bye. Alright, Cassie, you're done. You're done for.
This is not good. I gotta stop this.
Convinced Master Ron and the staff here at the American Martial Arts Institute that we need a fight team. Now, I really don't care about getting in the ring or getting hit myself, but the one goal I have is to punch Scott in the face as hard as I can, as many times I can, without any sort of repercussion or payback or anything like that. And really, this, I guess, is the easiest way to do it. So, here we are.
So I'm training in American Karate for the past 2 years or so. And it's been a great experience, it really has. But I'm ready to get back to Kung Fu school, show these guys some of my karate skills, right? Two steps! Power! So, Master Ron gave me my old job back as the intern, and I'm gonna be helping around the school, holding the pads during the fight training, being sparring partner for everyone. It's gonna be great.
I get my inspiration from, from Rocky movies. I let the guys know that I've had visions or dreams, but between you and me, Rocky 1, Rocky 2, Rocky 3, Rocky 4, even Rambo, there's some good stuff there too. What qualifies me as a coach? Interesting question. I mean, if you look at my list of work, I'm a teacher, a motivator, an encourager. I could probably go on the speaking circuit if I wanted, but I dedicate my time to raising up these men who in turn raise up other men and women and boys and girls. So really, if you think about it, coaching would be the next step on the teaching evolutionary journey.
Hey, real quick, before we get started. I'm sorry, I know.
What? Glasses? You don't even wear glasses.
Sure I do. You don't want me to hit you in the face really, really hard, do you? Everybody knows that I wear glasses.
Well, I can't hit you really, really, really hard in the face if you're wearing glasses.
Even with your twisted moral code, I kind of figured that you wouldn't hit me with glasses.
What?
Glasses.